It's Jody's Corner. It's the place where you wanna be. Saying the wrong thing, get you a bean, man.
It's your boy Jody Joe. Welcome to Jody's Corner. Thank you guys so very much for being here. I'm Jody Joe, and I'm here with the homie E.
What's poppin', YouTube, man? You know what it is.
And the man, the myth, the legend, the code is here.
I have arrived. Let's get it.
What are we talking about here today, bro? This is for the members of Tier 3 who put that out for us. Shout out to the members of Tier 3 memberships who hit the join button down below. Become members. We are starting to reward and fulfill all the tiers for the members, baby. And they wanted this discussion right here, bro. They wanted us to talk about what is our top five
movie scores
all time. Okay. Top five, you know.
Okay. Top five.
They had issues with it at first. Guys, I want to let you guys know that the league, meaning Code and E, it was having some tough time with this sheet.
Hard,
especially Code trying to get his scores together. We almost couldn't do the video because Code was having issues finding five scores.
But I don't really care about the scores. That's why.
It's so many epic scores out there, and it's hard to choose from. It's like there's so many I'm sure that in my list that I didn't even get, bro, because there's so many epic ones that's out there, and you know that's fire. And shout out to this guy for putting me on to scores.
Correct. I had to put my man E onto the scores and shit. We have our top five. Understand that if we had more time to think, because we crunched, we thought for a little while. They came up with their list. I went off the top of my head. But if we had more time to think about it, we could have delved in something more. Like, you really got to sit down and think for hours about all the movies you've seen and all the scores. But if you think about it, really good scores, they just jump out to you.
Yeah.
So maybe it shouldn't take that long.
I guess.
So let's start from 5 to 1.
Okay.
Let's start with the fifth greatest score. We'll give our fifth. Talk about it. Say whatever you want. And then until we get to the number one. Sound good? Sound good?
Sure, bro. Sure.
All right, Code, you're up first, man. What's your fifth greatest score of all time, bro?
It's got to be Nolan's Batman theme.
Nolan's The Dark Knight Trilogy. Now, we're talking about all three movies because even though they're different scores, it's really the same score, but they're altered for different films.
Yeah.
But it's genuinely the same feel, style, sound.
Right. And while this theme, I believe the only reason, not just the only reason, but I believe this theme is, it's an iconic theme to me, but personally, because I recognize it when I hear it, but I don't think people recognize it when they hear it like that. And I think it's because it's not old. You know, like it's not something that's being used consistently with Batman. It's only with the Nolan trilogy. You get what I'm saying?
I got you.
Yeah, so maybe I feel like if it was a theme that was consistently used.
I feel people are going to remember it, though.
No, I feel like people like me will remember it, but I feel like people won't remember it as a Batman theme. They'll remember it as a Nolan trilogy theme. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So that's why it's number five for me. And also because I really love it despite that. You know what I'm saying? So that's why I put it there at number five.
Solid pick, bro. What's up? What's your number five?
Number five is the Loki score, bro. That ding. I can feel that shit. That shit is hot to me. You know what I'm saying? From the whole
beginning. Now, it's movie scores, but I chose to make an exception because E had a hard time coming up with five film scores. So I'm like, freaking, bro.
It's a good theme, though. It's a good theme.
That shit fire, bro. I like the fix. I like exactly what happened in it. And, you know, I remember the details of the situation, didn't that? You know, that shit got
hook.
You know what I mean?
That hook.
It just hit hard, bro. When you hear it, you're like, fuck!
That hook!
And I connected with that shit, bro. So it's like, this has to be it. Now, there's other things that I want to go by, but this hits.
Yeah, it hits, bro.
Fire score. For me, this one, I'm going to say number five is... It's more classic, but every time I think about it, it just takes me back to a good time. It takes me back to feeling like a little kid. And my number fifth all-time greatest score is going to go to Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory, man.
Great score.
Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory.
Great score. Da, 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 da.
Which has a song, and they made the score the song. Often the score, the soundtrack, and the score are not the same, but with Willy Wonka, the score and the soundtrack, the main score and soundtrack have the same theme, which is freaking dope, bro. And Pure Imagination is just one of those amazing songs that will never, ever grow old. I love Willy Wonka. It's in my top five. It's in my top 10. But of movies of all time.
Right.
But as far as the score, I gotta put this top five, man.
Hey, bro, that's epic score.
It's just that good, bro. Shout out to Gene Wilder, bro.
Hold your breath. Make a wish. That's it.
Come with me.
Hold your breath. We'll begin with a spin, traveling in the world of my creation. What we'll see will defy explanation.
If you want to view paradise, simply look around and view it. If you want to view paradise, simply look around and view it. Number five, Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory. All right, moving on to score number four.
Four.
What's your fourth slot, bro?
My
talk to me.
Fourth slot goes to the Raimi Spider-Man trilogy, I guess. That Spider-Man theme, that score for those specifically for those movies, because.
Are you talking about all three?
Yeah, I don't know if it plays in all of them, but I know it plays for sure in one and two, I believe. So I'm assuming it's also in three. The one with the little, I'm terrible at mimicking that shit. But anyways, I like that score specifically because before then, Spider-Man in my mind didn't have a score. You know what I'm saying?
Danny Elfman is the composer.
Yeah. So before then, Spider-Man didn't have a score. I didn't have a music that I associated with Spider-Man outside of the... That shit. Oh, my goodness. This shit hits for me. Bro. It's... I don't know. Give that boy Danny his props. Because when I hear this, I think Spider-Man. Yeah, bro. Off top. I think Spider-Man. Bro. Yeah. It hits for me, man. It hits for me.
Very nice.
Yeah. So that's where I'm at with that one, man. It's just, to me, it's a theme that matches Spider-Man so much that I associate it with him now. Even better than that. Spider-Man.
That's trash.
Yeah.
It's funny and corny to talk about it, but it's
trash. Yeah.
All right, Spider-Man, good. What about you, E?
My fourth is Star Wars Duel of Fate. That shit.
That's a hitter.
Fire, bro.
That's on another level right there.
Song, I was like, okay, but while watching this movie, seeing it, I could just think about it.
Oh, there it is.
God, bro. It just hit. That,
you need a bucket?
That hit.
You need a bucket?
Bro.
It's just, I need a bucket.
It's just everywhere. It just hit everywhere. You're just like, oh, shit. It's about to go. Yeah.
Darth Maul, that nigga, bro. The prequels is that freaking show. That's the series, bro. The prequels, bro.
Seeing Obi-Wan do his thing, bruh. Just
buckets of comfort. This thing,
bro. It just hit hard.
It does. Can't go wrong with
taking
the Star
shower
Wars
here and this shit.
John
like,
Williams. Woo! A lot of John Williams and Hans Zimmer gonna be in this shit. Telling you, man, that's a good one.
Yeah, that's a hitter, bro. Can't miss with that one.
So, Duel of the Fates is your number four.
Right in the pocket.
All right, for sure.
Fire, bro. Fire.
For me, it is this film here. Really, it's Hans Zimmer, of course, another Hans Zimmer joint. This makes me feel at peace, at ease. The score for this whole entire film is beautiful. It's elegant. It's sad. It's soft. It's historic. And this is one of the greatest movies that Tom Cruise has ever made. This is Tom Cruise's best movie, The Last Samurai. Scored by Hans Zimmer is truly freaking amazing and epic, bro. So that's where I'm at. It's a beautiful, amazing score that really lends itself to the film. It has, in the sad moments, it helps. In the high moments, the lows, the battle war sequences, bro. Hans Zimmer flexed his swag on this entire movie, bro. Hans Zimmer is always up there flirting with John Williams. Like, some people got John, some people got Hans. There's a lot of other good ones in there in the mix, but what Hans Zimmer does right here with the score of The Last Samurai, bro, is really beautiful, man.
When the music can match the tone of the movie, bro.
If you hit a score that matches what you see on screen,
you're killing it.
And that's the most important thing, is to match what's seen on screen.
Yep.
The emotion.
Yep.
To let that emotion hit. And Hans does a really good job of that with this score. And I got The Last Samurai as my number four, bro. All right. We're at the top three.
Three for four. Yeah, three for four.
Cole, what's up, bro?
Number three, let me check the list. Number three, now I turn into Willy Wonka with you now. I don't have Willy Wonka, but I'm doing the childhood thing because that Indiana Jones theme, bro.
Ah!
Bro, that Indiana Jones theme, bro. I can't. Growing up, hearing that shit, bro. That shit's iconic.
Oh, shit.
Need I say more? That shit's iconic. And they always played in the movies, so.
Oh, there's a lot.
That's a fire pick, bro. That's
a fire pick. Bro, that shit's iconic. I mean, it has the advantage of being iconic, but I feel like it's only iconic because it's that good. It has that epic sense of adventure, you know what I'm saying? Play that shit. Let me see if that's it.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah.
It gives you that weird sense of adventure, which the movie does.
Very adventurous.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, it's got that adventure feel. I don't know how they do that shit, bro.
John Williams is how they do that.
Hey, that man's a legend. I mean, freak. Bro, that shit is. And
I remember at the end of The Last Crusade, and they're just sitting there on their horses and shit. You know, Sam going back home, we're done, you know. I told you to call me Indiana. We named the dog Indiana. The dog? You were named after the dog? Got a lot of fond memories of that dog. After you, sir. After you, Junior. Yes, sir. Ha! Right through the tunnels and shit. And they all joined up.
Bro, it's an adventurous theme.
Yeah, of course, bro. Spielberg and John Williams together. Absolute fire.
Yeah, that's a perfect example of music matching tone of movie. It's just, it ain't got to be sad. It ain't got to be angry or what. It just got to match. And when it match, it hits, bro.
Factual.
So
I love it. Oh, that's a good pick. That's number three.
Yeah, it's number three.
All right. E, what's up with you, dog?
All right, bro. My next one. I love this shit. This shit hit hard. Superman, bro.
Oh, wow.
Superman, it hit so hard, bro. It just make you just want to take off.
Like, so are we talking about the main theme?
Yes.
Just Superman, period.
Yeah, the main theme.
Yeah, bro. That shit hit
so hard, bro. That hoe. Hero's coming. Get out the way.
And then you hear the.
Yeah. I think that's what.
Hey, god dang, bro. Hey, that's some good shit, bro.
Yeah, that's a fire
theme,
bro.
That's some good shit, bro. I love that shit, bro. The greatest superhero score of all time.
Bro, again, it just, I don't know if it's the theme or the Superman.
It's both. It's Superman.
It matches.
The theme.
It makes you think of, he about to fly. Like, it just.
Here comes Superman.
Yeah, like, somebody.
Here come a hero.
Yeah, somebody's flying. Let's go. I'm out of here, buddy. It just matches. I don't know how they do it. It's crazy. That shit's crazy. How it matches like that.
Why? So you got that one as your number three, right?
Yeah. That's legendary.
All right, tight.
That's legendary, bro.
It's really.
That's some crazy number three shit. God damn.
What'd you say?
That number three is fucking heavy for him.
I love that shit.
That
bro.
One's big.
Let me see. For me, my number three pick would have to be Superman as well.
Okay.
It's crazy because we have the same number three.
Y'all. Fuck. That's we crazy. Talk.
We didn't say no. Shit. Just let you guys know.
Yeah, we did our list independently.
We did our own shit on our own. So nobody, you stealing the same shit as. No.
Me and I'm going to pick a different part. This score is almost just as good as the main title. John Williams flexes the love between Superman and Lois.
Okay.
The Can You Read My Mind? This is beautiful.
That's his really favorite.
That's why I'm telling you the flute is a very. That's my number two. I got the violin, and then the flute was my favorite instruments, bro. John Williams is straight GOAT status, bro. And what he did here with Superman, he changed Superman forever.
Yep.
He put Superman in a classic, iconic position until human history is gone. Like, that's what I'm talking. Like, this theme will not be top. I just can't see it.
I can't see it either.
It's just that good, bro.
I can't see it.
So, John Williams, once again, John Williams is coming to say hello. The Superman 1978 original theme that you get in Superman and you get it in Superman 2. You get, you know what I'm saying? You get it throughout all four of them. But hands down, this film right here and the score combined with it, truly glorious GOAT status. Why should not the number one all-time superhero score be on this list?
Yeah,
it deserves to be here.
Facts,
bro.
Facts.
So there it is. All right, Coat.
Where we at?
Top two. We're at number two, bro.
Number two. Number two. I got Superman, bro. The Superman theme.
Oh,
it shows
shit.
Up again. It shows up again, bro.
Let's go.
It shows up again.
So we're talking about that main theme.
Yeah, that main theme, bro.
That's right.
I hate Superman, but there's no bias here. That theme, you cannot deny it. I can't deny it. And as epic as that theme is, and as much as I love Spider-Man, I can't even say I wish that was his theme. It just don't match. You know what I'm saying? That shit just don't match. Bro, this shit hits, bro. This shit hits. They should have already known. They should have already known this shit coming back on this one. Number two, baby.
I'm like, I just hear this shit. What do you want to do?
It hit.
Look at that smile, bro. That's it. Okay.
It hit. This shit just hits, bro. What's crazy though, like you said, for you it's the violin and the flute.
Yeah.
For me,
piano guy.
The piano's king. But what's crazy to me is, as much as I love the piano, those are trumpets.
Yeah.
And that shit, I can't find a piano theme to top that theme. Right, and I love the piano. That's crazy to me, bro.
Yeah.
That just shows, I guess, his talent with
piano has a sound that doesn't really often align itself with epic. It lines itself with beauty.
I guess.
Trumpets are epic,
sure,
glorious,
sure.
Loud.
But even so, I prefer the piano sound. But like I said, I can't find a theme with the piano, the top sound. Even the ones I really love. But
can a piano sound epic?
I think it can.
I don't know of any scores that use usually pianos are very elegant.
I think it can because it has that strong. I don't know instruments. It has that dong shit. Yeah, it has that. But I think it can. But my number two is the violin, obviously. That's the queen. Piano's king, violin is queen. But who would have thunk it? The trumpet is freaking tearing shit up.
All right, that's his number two. What about you, bro?
Number two, the different pick, hard pick, but I like this a lot. I enjoy it. This fool played it 24/7 in his old whip. Like, McDonald's.
Oh, damn, I was scared just now.
This fool playing this shit like back and forth. I'm like, why does keep playing this shit? But then it just, I start feeling it, seeing this movie, enjoyed everything about it. Batman Begins, man.
Hey!
Begins.
Okay. So you're gonna go Batman Begins?
Yep.
Batman Begins, go ahead and tell us why.
I love this movie. I enjoy this movie a lot, but also too, the score, it hits so hard too, man. I mean, I can feel it, bro. When I do it, I wanna just go stand on a fucking ledge and be like, Batman. Like, I need that shit, bro.
Okay.
It hits so. I'm a huge Batman fan. So seeing this, even though I have my grips at first about a little bit of shit, but I love this movie, man. And everything about this score. You know, I mean, I've never been a person that listens to scores like that. This guy, like I said, put me on, but hearing the score, you can feel that shit in your soul. You can feel it in your body. You know what I'm saying? You can feel that shit. You get, I get tingles when I hear this shit. You know what I'm saying? Back and forth.
It's your jam?
This my hit.
Now, which one are we talking about?
Yeah, which one are you talking about?
The first. Then.
Hey, that shit hit too. This shit
hit. Talking about the epic, the.
This shit hit too.
Yep.
That shit does hit.
This
that
is
shit,
the hit. The main sheet.
Yeah, that shit hit.
Duh.
That shit hits.
Piano way, dude. Bro. You can feel the whole whip to it.
Yeah, this shit hits. You ain't lying.
That shit hit.
This shit hit. You ain't lying about that.
This shit goes.
It does, it does.
I did use some play this in my car.
24-7.
He scared the shit out of me when he said play in your car. I'm like, here come that euphoria joint, bro. I ain't trying to hear that.
That was just recently.
That's why I was scared, bro. That's a, I was scared.
Another TV show, man.
That's why I said scared, old bro. School in his car.
Yeah, when I heard the old school, I was like, all right, yeah, bro.
All right. Safe.
I'm about to hear the.
That's that shit, bro.
I ain't trying to hear that.
That's porn music you do.
Bro, that's what happens with that shit.
What are you talking about?
The euphoria shit.
Nah,
it's
that's
just a dude screaming.
Heard it so many times.
I'm like, bro, stop.
Nah, bro.
I ain't trying to hear that. I ain't trying to hear that shit.
You tripping, bro. All right, number two for me?
Yep.
Number two for me, wow. Hans Zimmer's coming to play here. This is the greatest. It's probably the greatest sci-fi cinematic film of all time, bro. This is one of the best scores I've ever heard in my life. And I often play it on Jody's Corner. Often. It's Hans Zimmer with 2014's Interstellar. This score, single-handedly, is arguably...
It's good.
One of those most epic, tingly feeling, especially when it lends itself to this, to the, what's happening on screen.
Right, right, right. It does.
When it lends itself to what's happening on screen, where Murphy has to align his rotation with the rotation of the destroyed ship that is spinning in outer space, that's going to end humanity.
He has a sense of grand scale. This thing.
You have a. You talk about clutch gene. You talk about being clutch. Michael Jordan, Kobe Bryant. Nah, this was the most clutch thing
you
in the history of humanity,
perfect.
Nigga. And yes, we went perfect, nigga. You joined that Patreon.
That's why we special.
And then once it hits, bro. It's over, bro. Once that score hit, it's done. It leads you up, it plays with you a little bit, and then it starts to hit and unravel, bro. It just guides you here and lets you flow. And then you'll know when the chaos hit. It's like, okay, things are serious, things gotta go. And then the riff is gonna change
right.
into something totally else. And then it riles up, and then it goes.
It picks up with what's going on screen.
Facts.
Yeah, I saw the movie.
It's tight, but it sounds like it could be in a Dracula movie or something like that. Because I had a riff, had a piano verse.
It's good. What do you, it sound like that shit that they, what do you call that shit where it's like the piano?
Organ.
But they got the big.
Organs. It's an organ.
You got the big shit connected
organ.
To it? That's what it's called?
Yeah, it's organ.
Sounds like that.
Yes.
Like it amplifies that piano.
I'm playing this shit, I don't give a fuck.
They gonna get it.
They gonna copyright this shit. Don't get free. We're doing this for the members.
Everything we get.
Shout out to the members of Jody's Corner, bro.
Right here.
That made this happen.
Right here sound like a Final Fantasy theme, bro. That.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then it just builds.
Yeah, it builds. Does.
You hear that piano work?
It's building.
Yeah, I hear it in the back. I hear it in the back.
Interstellar to the skies, making the whole thing delicious.
Tell it to swag.
What's happening? It's not done though. Built up.
Woo!
Epic shit is happening on screen. Beyond the horizon kicks in and he gets it done like MJ and Kobe in the clutch. Woo! My friend. Hans Zimmer flexes the cock all over this shit. I'm sorry. It's one of the best things I've heard ever, bro. It's great. Number one.
Number one.
All right, Cole. It's all on you, big boy.
All right, number one,
the
bro.
The time has come, Cole.
We have arrived. This was tough for me. This was tough for me. Because that Superman is my number two. And that shit hits. That shit was about to be number one, if I'm being honest.
I feel you.
But since I don't like his movies.
I'm interested in what is number one for this motherfucker.
Bro, it's that main Star Wars theme, bro.
Oh.
Bro.
Hey.
Bro.
That's John Williams again.
It don't know. If I love, let me tell you something right now. If I love Superman the way you did, that shit would have been number one. Because it's just for the love. Bro. Bro, this shit right here, it's over, bro. It's over once I hear this, bro. It's over once I hear this shit. And then you got that thing, let's go.
What's going on? Taking a word coming out?
It's over. This part, bro. Bro.
Nice, bro.
Once That's I hear great. This shit, and then this theme right here, every iteration or version of this theme that I've heard, when they do it strong, when they build up to it, it don't matter. Whenever I hear this shit, in every version.
You like this above the Tatooine one, the Force?
Yeah. Yeah. I think that, to me, that's the same version of that. It's just softer.
It's totally different.
Oh, okay. It's that different. One hits too. That one hits
that's
too.
That's my favorite Star Wars.
That one hits too.
Yeah.
They all hit. But this one takes me back. You know, New Hope is my favorite movie.
Yeah.
And this is the theme that started it all for me. Star Wars, bro. So that's my number one, bro. That shit hits.
Star Wars almost made my list, bro. It almost made it. It's so epic and used. But this is the one that I, this is not my number one, but this is, do you have?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Here's the one that's my favorite Star Wars.
Okay, okay.
Yeah.
This one here. I think it's going to get there. It's 16 minutes, bro.
Is this the... Sound like a different version of the same shit. Oh, I know what you're doing. I know what you're talking about. Is this... This ain't it. I know what you're talking about. The Tatooine one.
This is it. It just comes and goes.
I know what you're talking about. When Luke was looking off into the two suns and shit. I know exactly what you're talking about. That shit hits.
It's called Binary Sunset.
That shit hits. Let's see, it has that shit in there. That's what I thought it was.
No, they added it all with this one.
Oh, okay.
This is weird.
I thought they added that shit in there because I never listened to the whole thing.
I'll find it later. You guys know what I'm talking about, though. All right.
I know exactly what you're talking about.
E, what's up?
All right, man. I love this score. Like, I really, really love this score.
How much do you love the score?
Every fucking day.
This is your number one, isn't it?
Yes. I get this shit every fucking day. I hate the fact what the director did to this movie, though. But the movie, great. I hate what they did to the character, bro. And it's very, very, very irritating. But... I can hear this score every day. I love this. I can feel it. I feel this in my inner body.
In my inner body.
It's like it really? it just pulls me in. Like this song. Like I said, the other one is a hero. This song make you automatically want to fucking jump in the sky and fly.
Green Arrow better not
fucking
have a
Man
theme.
Of Steel, bro.
Oh damn.
That the whole fucking shit of him keep testing. Keep going. Test your limit, bro. When that shit hit so fucking hard, bro. Oh my fucking God, bro. This is nut buckets everywhere.
Hans Zimmer. Hans Zimmer strikes again. This is a great score, man. It's great. It's fantastic. That's a good one, bro.
I think this is a mix of the old one. Like the kind of...
Nah, he did this.
Obviously, he created something. No, he created something new. I hear elements of the old shit in
there. This is completely fresh. This is... Ooh, feel
this
it,
hits though.
Feel it, coach.
I feel it, bro. I feel it.
Get there.
This hits, bro.
Look at the
room. This hits, bro. It does.
This shit hits.
It does.
God dang, Zach Snyder, you ruined his whole shit.
Man!
You ain't shit.
That's why I want my boy to come back, man. He has the opportunity to prove so much.
Back. You want him back?
I want him back. I want him back. I need him back. It ain't even over.
You only go for the hook, bro.
That shit right there.
Yeah, there you go.
Woo! That shit hit!
It
that
does.
That shit hit! Good! I tell you, that shit hit. When I hear that, when I hear them,
ha ha! Hey, once them Africans come out to play.
Why is it that the best part of Man of Steel, if I could, like, take Man of Steel and pick out the best scene of it, it's very easy for me. It's when this score's playing, and it's when he smiles, and as he's flying, and he's just going. And he's like, what's up? Yeah,
bro. That shit is hot.
It's the best part of the whole score.
It's
the one time he actually shows him being Superman and smiling while he's flying. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I know what you're saying.
That shit is sad as freak.
Is it just me, or it's a little off topic, but the superhero landings, bro. I've never seen a superhero landing where they, you know how DBZ do the, they come down and the feet and they touch
the ground,
the tip first.
Oh,
that,
yeah.
That's cool and all. And then you got the crushing.
Yeah.
I've always wondered why they don't do the where you come down like you're going to smash, but you don't. Like you just stop and then dust. How come they never do that shit?
Because you, that's good to look at.
But yeah.
Like, narratively, that's to F with people.
I guess you know
he's being a douchebag if you do that.
I guess.
If Superman does that, he's clearly doing that to make an entrance.
No.
No,
he's doing it because he got to get here fast, but he don't want to hurt nobody. With that.
Remember when he told Lois and Man of Steel when he said,
that'd be
she was standing right next to him, he said, back up, and she stood right here.
That was tight.
Back up a little bit more. Mm-hmm. And you would think, like, why is he turning her back up? He's just about to take off. But he's turning her back up because all that air is finna hit so much, she finna blow her ass away.
Right. Right.
But yeah, that theme hits. You ain't lying.
That's a good theme. Code, you had a really good theme. This is no secret to people. They know what I'm picking.
Oh, what you're picking.
This is the single greatest piece of music I've ever heard in my life. And then when you factor in that it's tied to the single greatest film that has ever hit this planet, my number one favorite movie tied to my number one favorite movie and score of all time, A Gift of a Thistle, one of the scores that belong to the greatest film, Braveheart. This score here is everything that Braveheart is. It captures it all. Pain, joy, sadness, love, heartache, triumph, vigor, determination, beauty, savagery, pure, amazing.
Sound like some Ghost of Tsushima shit.
Thank you.
No, it's good. Yeah, it's good. The king came out to play. Ooh, we got a lot in here. Ooh! A lot of instruments up in this shit.
Oh, the Scottish freaking black.
What's that shit called? Yeah, I know what it is.
Come and say what's up. Bagpipe.
I heard the flute. I heard that shit. I heard the piano.
Violin,
you know
the violin?
That violin is
killing it, nigga. Everybody's up in here. God damn.
There you go. This is James Horner, bro. That's basically what you're gonna get. Braveheart is just that.
It's fine, bro.
That's a good pick, bro. That's a good pick.
James Horner, thank you very much.
That's a good pick.
James Horner. Rest in peace. Mm. He also did the score for Troy.
Oh, okay. Troy? Okay.
That's the one with Brad Pitt, right?
Yeah.
He also did the score for
good.
Movie Troy.
That was good.
And
that
they
good.
Have some similarities within
that
score.
That was good.
James Horner died a few years back. He flew his plane into a freaking mountain.
Oh, God
and died.
Damn.
Damn.
Yeah. Tough. Not on purpose.
No.
It was
actually,
a tragic
I understand.
Plane crash
I
where he...
lost control?
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, he crashed. He died in a plane crash years back.
Yeah.
So rest in peace to him. He created for me the single greatest piece of music to ever be a part of a film, man. James Horner, number one. There it is. That's the top five, baby. So, E, want to run down your top five again?
Yes, sir.
Cole, you got yours?
Yeah, I got mine.
We have Loki. We have Duel of Fate. We have Superman. We have Batman Begins. And we have Man of Steel.
Cole?
I got Batman, Superman. No, my bad. Batman.
Superman comes later.
Yeah, I jumbled it up. Indiana? Batman, Spider-Man, Indiana Jones, Superman, and that Star Wars that hits on another level.
That Star Wars is good. For me, I had Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory, The Last Samurai, Superman, Interstellar, and Braveheart. Let us know what y'all top five scores are. That's really nice. I like those scores, bro. None of these scores on here are bad. What is yours?
That's true.
Shout out to the members of Jody's Corner for recommending we do this video. I think it's one specifically was Jay Beast.
I could be wrong.
Jay Beast wanted us to do Disney Plus. Could this have been Knock Shadow? I don't know. Shout out to the members of Jody's Corner, man. The ones with the coins that show love. Thank you guys so very much for watching. I'm Jody Joe. That's E. That's Code. We out this thing. Deuces.
Like, comment, and subscribe, you guys. Thump that video, $3.99 all day. Don't forget to share and show love to the JC family. Let us know what you think about it. You like, you don't like it. Let us know what you think. Let us know what you love too, man. Come on, let us know what you enjoy, because you know we want to know too.
Do it
and do it now.